We're going to move on to the final lecture that we have prepared today. The final talk will be given by Dr. Pyeongkyun Choi, and he will talk about the clinical experience with COVID-19 in adult patients.
Thank you for interesting me. I'm Dr. Pyeongkyun Choi. Hello, and I'm an infectious disease physician, and I'm participating in treating severe COVID patient. 19 patients. I want to share our experience to you, and I hope this will be helpful for you. On February 24th, Chinese CDC published their surveillance data as of February 11th. According to the report, among 44,672 laboratory confirmed COVID-19 patients, 81% were classified as mild. Which included non-pneumonia and mild pneumonia cases. 40% were classified as severe, which was characterized by dyspnea, respiratory frequency over 30 per minute, blood oxygen saturation below 93%, and lung infiltrate over 50% within 24 or 48 hours. 5% of the patients were progressed to the critical cases that exhibited respiratory failure, septic shock, and multi-organ failure. The overall case fatality was 2.3%, and mortality rate increased with age, reaching 40.8% over the age of 80s. The mortality occurred only in the patient classified as critical, with the mortality rate of the 50% in this group. On February 2019, the detailed clinical characteristics of the 1,099 patients was released to New England Journal of Medicine. What's interesting about this data is that 35.7% of the patients who were classified as non-severe on admission also received the oxygen therapy during hospitalization, and even 2.8% of the patients were admitted to intensive care unit. So this data showed that the patient who presented as the mild case could progress to the severe case during the hospitalization. From the very early data from Wuhan, the median time from onset of symptom to first hospital admission was 7 days, to shortness of breath was 8 days, and to ALDS was 9 days, and to mechanical ventilator was 10.5 days. Recently, more detailed data about the clinical course in severe patients was published. Median time from illness onset to dyspnea was similar in survival group and non-survival group with 7 days, and the median duration of dyspnea is 13 days for survival groups. The sepsis developed at a median of 9 days after illness onset among the all patients, and followed by ALDS and acute cardiac injury and acute kidney injury and secondary infection and death. In Korea, the first COVID-19 case was a traveler from Wuhan, China in January 19th. Before February 20th, a huge outbreak occurred among a religious group in Daegu. Korean government has maintained a strong quarantine system, and the spread of COVID-19 was limited, and patient can be detected in the early course of the disease by the intensive quarantine system. Recently, the clinical characteristics of the earliest 28 COVID-19 cases was published, and I think this is a very unique group because we can find the patient in the very early course of the disease. The most common symptom at the time of admission for isolation was cough and sore throat, and diarrhea was present in 3 patients among initial symptoms, and 2 cases were asymptomatic when they were confirmed as COVID-19. The clinical feature of the COVID-19 during the prodromal phase was insidious and mild, and fever was absent in 75% of the patients at the time of admission. The throat symptoms such as the throat pain, discomfort, and globe sensation and cough were ranked as relatively common, but only one third had these symptoms. As the prodromal symptoms were mild and did not begin abruptly, most of the patients were not able to tell exactly when they had become ill. And because of this benign nature of the prodromal symptoms, they did not realize that they had been infected with SARS-CoV-2 and went out to carry on usual activities while spreading the virus inadvertently. And I think this is a key clinical characteristic of the high transmissibility of this COVID-19. And so the universal social distancing is the essential to prevent widespread of this virus. The most common finding of CT scan were bilateral ground glass opacities in the periphery of the lung. Although they had radiological pneumonia, they did not feel unwell and were able to carry on their daily activities as usual. So this means walking pneumonia. And the title of the SARS-CoV-2 shedding from the upper respiratory tract were very high from the prodromal phase of illness until day 5 of illness. In some patients, the dense nodular lesions were found. 70 patients developed fever and became afebrile during the hospitalization, and the median day of defeverance was 9 days, but the longest day is 18 days after the symptom onset. The median day of de-isolation was 18 days after symptom onset, and the longest is 27 days. The most important treatment for COVID-19 patients, especially severe patients, is the best supportive care. It includes antipyretics, hydration, oxygen therapy, mechanical ventilator, and when indicated, and extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, ECMO, can be life-saving in patients with severe form of ARDS patient. However, to maintain the proper ECMO program in hospital, it requires very intensive resources utilization and very substantial staff training and multidisciplinary team approach. As you know, no antiviral drugs have been proven to be effective with randomized controlled trial now. And our experience showed that severe COVID-19 patients have the following characteristics. First, there is some mismatch between the severity of the chest radiograph and the clinical symptoms. Even when chest radiograph showed extensive infiltrate in both lungs, but patients often do not complain about the shortness of breath. And the patient condition may remain relatively stable for a while and may deteriorate rapidly. And the treatment response to best supportive care seemed to be better than that of the worst COVID patient in our experience. Thank you very much for listening.